Hey there, and welcome to another tutorial. Today we're going to paint this Studio Ghibli scene with gouache.
So as for the supplies, I'm using different kinds of gouache and a fresh tube of white gouache. I'm also using different kinds of brushes, and I'm gonna try my best to link everything in the description box below as always. And now for some ambiance. I'm lighting some candles, and now I'm putting in the fresh white gouache, and I'm also using Arches watercolor paper, which I really, really love and enjoy using. And then I used some tape to get some clean borders. I like to do that, especially in my tutorials, because as soon as you remove the tape, it looks much more sophisticated, and that's especially very rewarding if you're a beginner at painting, but also if you are a professional at painting, this is still so much fun when you remove the paint. And now we're starting to mix a blue color. I was going back and forth a little bit with that color until I was happy with it. And then I tilted the paper a little bit, so I got a flat layer. So this is a kind of a trick where you can get a little bit more of a flat layer so it doesn't give you any puddles. And then I mixed a darker blue color, and this is going to be for all of the water in our piece. And I decided to do the water first, so I just mapped out where the water would be and did a bigger area of that. So I would paint on top of that with the green later on, and that gives it more of the effect that I was going for, that the blue is kind of hidden underneath the green. You'll see what I mean. And now I'm starting with the mountains. I just used some white to map out where the mountains would go, and just roughly painted them in. And we're gonna add a lot of details to that later. And now I'm starting off with the green, and I decided to do a little bit of a real-time footage here, because with tutorials, I never know whether I should go more for longer format videos or for shorter ones. The shorter ones are typically more interesting to watch, so I usually go for that, and my Skillshare courses are more for when you want a more real-time tutorial. They're also a little bit sped up, but they're more real time. And just so you know how fast I'm going when I'm painting, I decided to include this little clip here where I'm just filling the bottom part. And you can see it here, super slow actually. Most of the time you see everything sped up. And the entire piece took me about 2.5 hours. So if it takes you anything from 1 to 5 hours, that's totally normal. Take your time if you want to, or simplify the painting and do it quicker. Whatever you prefer, go for it. And there's no right or wrong here. We're trying to learn, and we're replicating a Studio Ghibli painting to just learn from the Studio Ghibli style. And now I'm filling all of this area with this green tone. This is just the first layer, but I was trying to get a green tone that I would be happy with in the end. And then I started to slowly, with a few blades of grass, I think then I went and did something else, but I just started trying it out with the grass here with a lighter tone, and just very simply did those lines and spread them out a little bit. And I was just getting started with the details here. And then I mixed this darker blue tone in between. I used my heating tool to heat everything and make it dry quicker. And then I used this darker blue tone and shaded the areas where there's shadows above the water, so you can see those edges of the grass, and it just makes it more three-dimensional. And that was also in the Studio Ghibli scene, so I was doing that here. And I think by doing the blue first and then going on top with the green, we really achieved this effect that the water is kind of beneath it, and that's what I was going for. So here I'm doing this with with every single piece with the water, and then I'm starting with the mountains in the background. And for that, I used a very bright purple tone. So I used a lot of white and a little bit of purple. I think I actually mixed blue and red, and maybe added a few other colors to desaturate it a little bit. You can really play around with this. And when it comes to replicating those Studio Ghibli pictures, I always have to stop myself from trying to replicate them completely and trying to make it all perfect, because that's not the point of doing this. We're here to learn. We're here to learn from this style. So if you're painting those mountains, don't worry if the blobs are exactly in the same position. We're just here to learn this, and doesn't have to look perfect, anything like that. So I'm using darker purple tones to add more shadows, and was going a little bit back and forth with this. And then I used a green tone to blend those grass bits, I assume it's grass in there, and just went over that, and then added in a little bit more shadow. So here I'm using an even darker purple tone, even more shadows, and then I went over this again with some white, so even more highlights, and just playing around with this. And again, here I really had to stop myself from trying to make it perfect. And now with those clouds or fog that's in the background, I started with white straight out of the tube. So this is the most opaque white that you're gonna get. And at first I painted it on with my regular brush. And then I used a brush that's a little bit more beaten up. So it doesn't have to be your favorite brush. Just use one that's a little bit more frizzled, or whatever the word for that would be. And here I'm still doing dots. But then I realized I needed more of this effect from a different brush. And you'll see that in a second, where I'm just doing the dots. And here you can see that. So I used that brush and just dot, dot, dot over all of this to make this texture. And then I used some white and did those highlights in the water. And I smudged that later on because I put my hand on it. So things like that happen. Be careful. Here you can see the smudging happen. I started with the blades of grass here in the foreground until I realized that I had smudged the white. And I think later on I went back and fixed that. So here I'm just doing the grass, and I started with one green tone, then I mixed a darker green tone, and I just played around with that. And what I really admire about the Studio Ghibli style, this piece is from Howl's Moving Castle, by the way. What I admire about it is that they always do layers really well. So you can see that sometimes the brighter tones are on top of the darker tones, but then there's another layer of darker tones even on top of that. So they do that really well, and it makes it look much more detailed and sophisticated. Then I mixed different pink tones. Excuse the shaky footage here. It gets better. It's just that one scene that's a little bit shaky. And I was just doing the flowers, which are just dots that are not completely round, so you just dot them on there and use the different pink tones. So brighter ones, mid-tones, darker ones. You can really go all in and make so many different tones of this, because that's the goal. We want it to look like there's a lot of different flowers there. And also we want them to be in bundles. So in the picture that I was using as a reference, everything was in bundles. So you can see those lines of flowers, and you can see the lines of the grass in between them. And that's what makes it look so good and so organic, because in nature, things come in bundles as well. There's always like a bundle of flowers and then a little bit of grass in between. That's in nature as well. That makes a painting look so much more interesting. Here you can see I was doing different kinds of flowers, and now I'm using a brighter green tone for even more blades of grass, and I was going over that darker area and also did the reflection in the water with that, just for that round. And yeah, here I'm doing that again because I made a little editing error here, so you could see it twice. But yeah, just adding everything in and building up the colors. It doesn't matter if you're starting off with the brighter tones when it comes to the flowers and then you're doing the darker ones, or in what order you want to do it. At the end of the day, we just want to create a lot of flowers and just dot them on there. And always make sure that your brush is not too wet. So I like to remove, here you can see it was a little bit too wet. I like to remove some of the water on the brush with a tissue or with the water can. So here I'm fixing the smudged area and I thought I would just wipe it off, but it didn't really work the way that I wanted it to. It also wiped off some of the blue, so I just painted over it with a very light layer of blue, just went over that. So if something like that happens to you, you're definitely not alone. Mistakes happens to the best of us. And yeah, I was not being careful and put my hand into the wet colors, so just had to fix that, and it was an easy fix. So here I'm starting to add more of the shadows and define those lines again that started to kind of go, they went missing, and also the lines from the clouds, because on the bottom part the clouds are very defined, it's a very straight line, and just on the top we want this stippling effect. And yeah, I was just going back and forth, and I like to go from right to left with my paintings because I'm left-handed. If you're right-handed, then feel free to go into the other direction, because then you're gonna make it easier on yourself and not smudge everything as easily as I'm doing here if I'm not being careful. So always go in a different direction from the hand that you're using to paint. So yeah, building up the flowers, and this was, I have to admit, a little bit tedious. Here I'm fixing the water now, and I built the color, the flowers for a while, and I had to put on some, I think I was listening to an audiobook or something to just distract my mind, had to take some breaks in between this. I was not doing this in one sitting, and if you don't want to, you don't have to do that either. Or you can just go through it in one sitting if you want to. Everything's allowed here. And I also want you to feel safe in making mistakes and learning, and yeah, that's very important to me. And yeah, I try to remind myself of that as well. And sometimes I'm also very hard on myself and pressure myself. And I want to get the point across that even though I am still hard on myself, I pressure myself, I'm trying to let that be okay as well. So if you are very critical of your art, don't beat yourself up for that, because that adds an additional layer of drama that's just not worth it in the end. So just accept that you're critical, but be aware of it and try to be less critical, but don't beat yourself up for that. I hope that makes sense. I'm always just trying to be kinder to myself, and also always tell my coaching clients to do the same thing, and I teach them how to be kinder to themselves, but because that's gonna motivate you in the end, and you're gonna be much more inclined to keep going if you are kind to yourself. And pushing yourself and beating yourself down is just not gonna work in the long run. So you can see I was building up a lot of the flowers, then did some more shading in the grass, some more blades, then I did more greenery on the mountain. So all everything, fixing up everything so that I was happy with the result. Then I removed the tape, and here we have the finished piece. This is what it looks like. And yeah, I really love this kind of style.
I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and if you did so, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye!